Am I at risk of developing Bell's palsy after COVID-19? Or else am I at risk of developing Bell's palsy after taking COVID-19 vaccine? If you want to know the answer of these two questions, make sure to stay with me till the end of this video. Let's begin. Host physiotherapist Meghna Dave, and welcome to YouTube channel Health Q, the place where my mission is to motivate you to look at the bright side of the health. In today's video, let's discuss about how much you are at risk of developing Bell's palsy if you have got COVID-19 infection or else if you have taken COVID-19 vaccine. Friends, every pandemic or any kind of epidemiologic condition where there are viral attacks involved and which spreads across regions and across people comes with some sort of secondary complication. You must have definitely heard of black fungus, how it affected so many people who had suffered from COVID-19 infection. Bell's palsy is also another possible complication that a person who has suffered from COVID-19 infection can develop. Since in many case studies, it has been reported that head, nose, throat and ear related infections and complications are very much high after COVID-19 infection, and Bell's palsy also comes under that category. Several studies have reported that COVID-19 has been associated with Bell's palsy infection. But when it comes to COVID-19 vaccine, the clinical trials that were done by different drug companies who were manufacturing the vaccines have observed that yes, people developed Bell's palsy episode after the vaccination, but this was not a significant number. If they compared the number of positive Bell's palsy cases in the controlled vaccinated group with the general incidence of Bell's palsy on a yearly level, it was almost the same. Hence, FDA disapproved this and said that no, there is no correlation between COVID-19 vaccine and Bell's palsy. So, the answer to your question is, yes, if you have got COVID-19 infection, you might develop Bell's palsy in future as a secondary complication, but your chances of getting that Bell's palsy reduces if you take COVID-19 vaccine. This was published in a study and research paper which was published in the Journal of JAMA Network, which mentioned that people who have got COVID-19 infection are at higher risk of developing Bell's palsy infection as well, but the people who have taken COVID-19 vaccination, in among them, the risk of developing Bell's palsy reduces. Annually, 15 to 30 people out of 1 lakh people develop Bell's palsy. And the recurrence rate of Bell's palsy among the people who have already developed Bell's palsy before is by 8%. So now the question arises that how come COVID-19 can lead to Bell's palsy infection? Now the hypothesis that has been mentioned in the research papers says that first that there is drop in the immunity level of a person. After which, whenever there is a viral attack that happens in a person or this person gets exposed to some sort of virus, especially the herpes simplex virus, which is mostly staying dormant in our body, gets affected by molecular mimicry, which means that the antibodies in our body think that these are some virulent virus that has again entered into the body and started overproducing the antibodies and started overfighting it. Due to which this extra response of immune system lead to development of Bell's palsy. To make it more simple, when you get COVID-19 infection, definitely there is a drop in your immunity level. But after that drop, whenever any other kind of viral infection that you develop, or else if you have herpes simplex virus lying inside your body in a dormant way, and then if there is an exaggeration or is there stress involved, this lead to molecular mimicry, which means your body's antibody think that there is some another outside virus which has re-entered the body, and body starts reacting to it in an overtly manner, which causes some changes in the body, and that includes the swelling inside the ear as well. This swelling further presses the nerve and leads to Bell's palsy. The data suggests that the rate of Bell's palsy is more in patients with COVID-19 infection, but the reported incidence of Bell's palsy is low in the people who have taken COVID-19 vaccine. But this is a too early claim to make, because still there is a lot of things that needs to be further researched in the space of COVID-19 infection and its relevance with Bell's palsy episode. There is limitation of time, limitation of data. That's why we cannot completely rely on all this research paper as of now. But yes, this is something that needs to be added up, that if you have got COVID-19 infection, you might be at risk of developing Bell's palsy. So now the key takeaway, what you can do so that you cannot get Bell's palsy. The only and only way to get away or else prevent yourself from getting Bell's palsy is to make sure that you boost up your immune system, work on your immunity level, stay away from flu-like symptoms, don't try to eat a lot of sweets, a lot of cold drinks, avoid things that causes inflammation in the body. Go for high fiber and plant-based diet over dairy products or else animal-based food. This will help you to maintain a general well-being, exercise well, stay active, all these things, and also stay stress-free. All these things will help you to stay away from Bell's palsy infection to an extent. I hope through this video, I could educate you and help you understand that if you have got COVID-19 infection, you might be at risk of developing Bell's palsy, but that doesn't mean that every person who has got COVID-19 infection will develop Bell's palsy. So on that note, I'll end this video here, and I'll see you in another video. Thank you.